Hi, I'm Jonathan Wild, and we cover how to account for installment notes with monthly payments. An installment note is a type of note payable that involves issuing a note in exchange for cash or other assets. In return, the issuer promises to pay back the principal of the note with interest through a series of payments to the lender. In this segment, we will cover installment notes with monthly payments, which are similar to monthly payments we might make for cars or student loans. All right, let's run through an example. So assume a company borrowed $20,000 cash from a bank on January 1st. In exchange, the company signs and issues a 5-year installment note to the bank with 12% interest and 60 monthly installment payments of $445 that include interest and principal. For the company to record the issuance of the note, we debit cash for $20,000 and credit notes payable for $20,000. Next, an installment payment is made at the end of each month for the next 5 years of the loan. However, when recording the monthly installment payment, we need to determine what portion of the payment goes towards accrued interest expense and which portion goes towards paying down part of the amount borrowed or the principal of the note. To do this, we use something called an installment note amortization schedule. So let's set up our table. First, let's add a column for the period end or monthly payment dates. The note was issued on January 1st of year one, so the first period end and payment date is January 31st of year one. The next column is the beginning balance for each monthly period. In the first month, it is $20,000, as the note was just issued. The next column is interest expense, which is computed as the beginning balance multiplied by the interest rate of 12% and multiplied by 1 over 12 months. We do this as the interest rate on the note is annual and we need a monthly rate, hence the 1 over 12 months. So for January 31st of year one, $20,000 is multiplied by 12%, which is then multiplied by 1 over 12 months to get $200 of interest expense. This means that the January 31st year one installment note payment of $445 included $200 of interest expense. The next column determines the portion of the installment payment that reduces the principal that is owed. This is computed as the $445 monthly installment note payment minus the $200 interest expense to get $245. This amount goes towards paying back the principal amount borrowed and therefore reduces the notes payable account balance. The next column is the cash installment payment of $445 for each month of the next 5 years. The last column is ending balance, which is the beginning balance of the note minus the amount of the installment payment that went towards paying back principal. On January 31st of year one, this is $20,000 minus $245, which gets us an ending balance of $19,755. Now to begin the February 28th payment, we take the ending balance after the prior month's payments, and that becomes this period's beginning balance. We apply the same procedures as we did in January to February, and then further to March and April, where we end our demonstration of the amortization table. In business, we would keep going all the way until the end of the 5 years of the note, which would include a total of 60 payments. Next, let's record monthly installment note payments, which is much easier after doing the amortization table. So for January 31st of year one, we record a debit to interest expense for $200, a debit to notes payable for $245, and a credit to cash for $445. The debit to interest expense increases that expense account and reflects the annual interest on the note. The debit to notes payable reduces the balance in that liability account, recognizing that we have now paid back a portion of the principal of the note through an installment payment. We credit cash for $445, as this is the installment payment amount made at each period end. For the February installment payment entry, each of the account titles remains the same. Just the amounts will change based on the numbers we pull from the amortization table. The same is true for March and April. At the end of the 5 years, the note is paid off through 60 monthly installment payments, and the final balance in notes payable is zero.